Very good evening. Welcome to State of Business on Art Television. I'm Ashing Sunny Veerasinghe. Let's have a look at the headlines first. NPP questions the transparency factor of the MCC agreement. Collective of civil society groups urges the submission of assets and liability declarations by the candidates before the elections. News in detail. President Gotabaya Rajapaksa stresses that unnecessary interference by the government can hinder the development of small-scale businesses, and instead the government should assist those by rendering support for facilities and skills development. President Rajapaksa made this observation at yesterday's meeting held to discuss the issues of the hairdressers and beauticians. Accordingly, President Gotabaya Rajapaksa said that it is the responsibility of the government to enhance the professionalism, finance facilities and trade promotion potential of those engaged in the field of beauty and hairstyle. In the meantime, as per the request of many, President agreed to extend the assistance of the National Enterprise Development Authority to uplift the beauty industry. There are over 90,000 small, medium and large-scale beauty salons across the country, and over 400,000 people are being employed in this sector, and the number of families dependent on them is about 1.5 million. Thus, it was discussed at length how the training can be improved to meet the high standards of the industry. President also instructed officials to arrange the conduct of the national vocational qualification levels in 5th, 6th and 7th stages in all three languages, Sinhala, Tamil and English. Representatives of the National People's Power stress that the consequences to be experienced in the future will be more dangerous than the short-term benefits which you are to experience if the country signs the Millennium Challenge Cooperation Agreement. National People's Power officials made these revelations holding a media briefing in Colombo this morning.
අපි එදත් කිව්ව මේ විශ්ලේෂණය කරලා කරුණු සහිතව මෙන්න මේ වාසි තියෙනවා මේ වාසි වලට වඩා අවාසි ගොඩාක් වැඩි. ඒත් අපි මහ ජනතාවගෙන් අහන ප්‍රශ්නේ, බුද්ධිමතුන්ගෙන් අහන ප්‍රශ්නේ, ඕගොල්ලෝ සූදානම්ද මාර කලින් කිව්ව කෙටි කාලීන ආර්ථික ප්‍රතිලාභයට හිලව් කරන්න ඕගොල්ලන්ගේ දිගු කාලීන අනාගත පරම්පරාවේ ආර්ථික ව්‍යසනය. මේ රටේ දේශපාලන අයිතිය, සිවිල් අයිතිය, මානුෂික අයිතිය, ප්‍රජාතන්ත්‍රවාදී අයිතීන් ටික හිලව් කරන්න කැමතිද? MCC වෙබ්සයිට් එකේ මේ ඇග්‍රීමන්ට් එකේම තියෙනවා. මේ ප්‍රධාන කාරණයක් තමයි මේ ව්‍යාපෘතියේ ක්‍රියාත්මක වෙනකොට ට්‍රාන්ස්පරන්සි ඇන් ඇකවුන්ටබිලිටි. පාරදෘශ්‍යභාවයත් ඒ වගවීමත් තියෙනට ඕනයි කියලා. ඒතර ඇත්තටම මේගොල්ලන්ගේ පැත්තේ ඒක යම් තාක් දුරකට කරනවා. 2006 ඉඳලා මේ වෙබ්සයිට් එකේම අප්ඩේට් වෙලා තියෙනවා. ඒතර අපි අපේ මිනිස්සුන්ගෙන් අහන්නට ඕනේ කෝ අපේ පාරදෘශ්‍යභාවය. ඒතර අපේ පාරදෘශ්‍යභාවය රැකලා නෙමෙයි නම් අපි ඉන්නේ. ඇමරිකාවටත් වගේ කීමක් තියෙනවා කතා කරනකොට උඹලා උඹලගේ පාරදෘශ්‍යභාවය රැකලා නැහැ මේ ව්‍යාපෘතිය කරන්න බෑ. අපි මහ ජනතාව පවා මේක දැනගත්තේ ගිය අවුරුද්දේ මේ කරලියට ආපුවම ඇමතිවරේ මේක පාර්ලිමේන්තුවට ඉදිරිපත් කරාට පස්සේ. එතකොට මේක මහ ජනතාවත් එක්ක සාකච්ඡා නොකරපු ව්‍යාපෘතියක්. නමුත් මේකේ මූලික කොන්දේසි වලට අනුව ඒක අපි සාකච්ඡා කරන්න ඕනේ. මේ වෙබ්සයිට් එකේ මුලින් කියනවා මේක ස්වාධීන ආයතනයක් කියලා. NCC MCC කියලා ස්වාධීන එකක් කියලා. ඒතර ස්වාධීන එකක් නෙමෙයි. මේක ස්වාධීනම කියන්නේ රජයෙන් වෙන් කරලා වෙනමම වැඩේ කරන් යන්න ආයතනයක් විදිහට තියෙනවා. නමුත් රාජ්‍ය ප්‍රතිපත්තිය, ඇමරිකන් ප්‍රතිපත්තිය, ඒ ඇමරිකන් ජනතාවට ආර්ථික වාසිය ලබා දීමේ ප්‍රතිපත්තිය අනුගමනය කරන උපක්‍රමශීලී ආයතනයක්. ඉතින් ඒක හොඳටම ඔප්පු වෙනවා මේ ටීම් එක දිහා හරියට බලපුවම.
Buddha Sasana, Cultural and Religious Affairs Ministry announces that all archaeological sites, monuments, premises, all museums operating under the National Museum Department and the Public Reference Division of the National Archives Department will be reopened for local tourists from next month under strict health guidelines. Accordingly, 9 coronavirus cases were identified within the country yesterday, increasing the total count of COVID-19 in Sri Lanka to 2010. Hence, 6 Navy officers and 3 Sea Marshals at the Boosa Quarantine Centre tested positive for the virus yesterday. The total number of coronavirus recoveries from the Navy has reached 820. Thus, the number of recoveries from coronavirus is 1,619 as of 3 p.m. today. Moreover, a special Sri Lankan Airlines flight carrying 171 Sri Lankans who were stranded in Lebanon landed at the country this morning. The passengers and crew members of the flight were subjected to PCR tests within the airport premises upon arrival. Meanwhile, an association of working journalists in Sri Lanka, Asian Media and Cultural Association, had organized a function to invoke blessings for all the communities in India who were contracted with the coronavirus. The religious activities took place at Maliga Kanda Agrashavaka Mahavihara premises under the auspices of Sri Lanka Mahabodhi Society Chairman, Most Venerable Banagala Upatissa Nayaka Thera. The event was attended by Indian High Commissioner in Sri Lanka, Gopal Bagle, and he highly appreciated the thoughtful move by the Asian Media and Cultural Association.
Contributed to giving out the message of brotherhood, message of camaraderie, and common bond between the two countries, which rests on the very solid foundation of Buddhism, the message of Lord Buddha to the entire world. And it is my good fortune to be standing here today at one of the places which is so closely associated with the legacy of Lord Buddha. I consider it a privilege. Thank you very much for this opportunity. Thank you for praying for India, for Sri Lanka, and for the world. Thank you very much. Bahumai Stuti.
Stay tuned for more news after this short break. Welcome back after the break. March 12 Movement, which is a collective of civil society organizations, urges the candidates of the forthcoming parliamentary election to submit their asset and liability declarations to the public as it's their prime responsibility. In the meantime, addressing yesterday's media briefing, convener of March 12 Movement, Rohan Hetiarachchi, added that the voters should elect proper candidates since they will be the future lawmakers of the country.
So as a March 12 Movement, we appeal all the political party and especially the candidate. If you are willing to be a clean man, if you want to show the public that you are willing to be a clean man in your parliamentary career, so the first step during this campaigning period, you should submit your asset and liability declarations to the public. As a March 12 Movement, we are happy to take it to the public. We have our March 12 website. All our organizations, we do have our website and also the Facebook page. Social media is quite powerful these days. So we are happy to carry this message to the public. So we urge all the political party, we urge all the candidates. There are about 7,452 candidates. It's a very high competition in these elections. So only 2.3% will be get elected out of this 7,000. In additionally, we urge the people, public of this citizens of this country, that you need to seriously monitor your candidate during next 1.5 months period, whether they are capable enough, whether they are qualified enough to be a parliamentary representations, because parliament is the legislations, and also they are the one who really look after your financial on behalf of the citizens. So they have to have a capability on that.
First Capital Holdings states that the trading in the stock market saw a positive reaction this week with the increase of banking activities owing to the reduction of the statutory reserve ratio.
This week was a positive week for the market, where on all the days we saw a significant improvement in the overall index. On Monday, the market managed to breach the 5,000 psychological barrier. After that, we saw a continuous uptrend in the overall market. Turnover levels were also pretty healthy, exceeding the 1 billion mark on most of the occasions. And with that, we saw the buying interest was mainly coming out of the local investors, mainly again going into the banking sector counters. We see these banking sector counters, especially commercial HNB Sampat, being the most favorite among the local investors. However, we are continuing to see foreign selling among the same counters, specifically on bulk of the days. On if you take this week, we saw foreign selling on all the days that were there. And the net foreign outflow month to date exceeded the 7 billion mark this week.
Speaking further, research head of First Capital Holdings, Dimantha Matthew, noted that even though the foreigners will reside more in the selling side in the coming week, it will be absorbed by the more active local investor participation, which will help to continue the positive momentum of the trading.
in the upcoming week, we feel that still the market is likely to continue to be positive, with the local investor sentiment being very positive, and there's a bit of speculation on the upcoming election as well. So with the government responding positively in relation to payment of the construction related activities where the government payments are due, there was a bit of a positive trend last week. We feel that that trend also can go into the coming week as well. So with that, in addition, we feel that the banking sector interest is likely to continue, with most of the banking sector counters trading well below its book values. And there is a number of positives that are coming into the banking sector with the SRR cut. There is a number of benefits that come into the banking sector. So with that, the positivity in the banking sector is likely to continue in the coming week as well. However, on the selling side, we feel that foreigners is likely to continue on the selling side. However, it is likely to be absorbed mostly by the local investors. So we feel that the overall index is likely to be on a positive momentum in the upcoming week as well.
We'll be back with stock updates after this break. Welcome back after the break. Trading at Colombo Stock Exchange ended on a positive note today. The all-share price index gained 17.8 points to close at 5,163.35, and the S&P SL20 gained 3.29 points to close at 2,290.85. The turnover was 1.2 billion rupees and over 47 million shares were traded. Up next are Forex Rates. And that's all the news for today. See you tomorrow with Biz Roundup at 8:30 p.m. Until then, take care. Have a good weekend.